ocean road that will take you there. Be informed and stay in tune. Uplift your soul and heal your wounds. Welcome to Bashment Bay. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Hello and welcome to another episode of Bashment Bay TV. I'm your host, Sharon Cummings.
And I'm Paulette Samuels. Welcome.
I am so excited about this show today because it's the day after Independence. So we'll be airing our show the day after Independence. But what a weekend it was. There were so many happenings. I know a lot happened in New York.
Yes, there was a lot going on here.
Did you go to the ball?
No, I didn't make it to the ball, you know, somehow I didn't make it to the ball, but I have been to a celebration that was very lovely happening here where I am in Queens. And as I said, there's a lot of celebration going on. You could hear it at like almost every part of the city that they were having all this going on.
There is so many things happening in Fort Lauderdale. I'm in Jacksonville right now. There's nothing happening here, but in Fort Lauderdale, there's so many happening that I wish I was there. But as you can see, that tells you what our topic is going to be. We're going to be celebrating Jamaica's independence, 60th anniversary. Can you imagine? 60 years.
Yeah.
So we'll be right back.
Estella's legacy. Grandma Estella, I have a question. Written by Sharon Cummings, Tamika Jones, and Charmaine Russell.
Welcome back. There is so much to celebrate, and I feel there's some nostalgia to this because I remember so well, without giving away my age, by the way, I'm not going to do that. I remember in 1962, when the Queen came and it's all the fanfare and everybody, because I was living on the street where the parade came by, all the cars. At that time, I was too young to understand, but now I know that it was a big deal. It was a big fanfare. And what I really remembered is she came out of her motorcade and she started walking along the sidewalk. And we as little kids were standing there and she came up to us, she bent over and said, "How are you doing?" in that very nice, polished English tone. You know, "How are you doing?" And she touched us. And then she went right along the way before she got back into her motorcade. So I can say I had a brush with the Queen. You know, not the wrong brush, the good brush with the Queen.
I'm not going to give away my age either, even though I'm very proud. My birthday just went. But I was on the 5, let's say. And I don't know how I remember this, but I remember one of my sisters dressing me and my other sister dressing her daughter. And I remember my sister, she used perfume on my eyebrow, you know, dressing me to look really nice. And my other sister who was dressing her daughter went like this and did her eyebrow. And that's all I remember from that day. I know we went to the stadium because that's where we were getting dressed to go. But that's what I remembered
about the Independence Day.
Yes. And going to the stadium. Yeah.
Right, right. Because I think that's where they were heading. You know, they were going along. She left the Parliament House or whatever that was down the street from where we were. Our street was like a thoroughfare. I mean, all the prime ministers who died, they would bury them in what was known as Race Course at the time. It's now Heroes Park because most of the Norman Manley was buried there. Bustamante was buried there, you know. So we saw all the fanfare going by just growing up as a kid, you know. Mm. So It was lovely.
As I said, I don't remember much, but I remember that day and I will not forget it. I think we had on like a skirt with crinoline.
Crinoline skirt, yep.
Yes. And I think I call it the Miss Lou material. I think it was made out of.
Yeah.
I remember that.
They took pictures that day. But at that time, you know, we didn't even have camera. Those were the people who had cameras, right? We didn't have anything. It's not like, you know, that is so way back from now, from today, selfies and cameras and, you know, phone cameras and all of that. So I know the newspaper had it, but we don't have a copy of it. Or we didn't know to ask.
There was a picture, I think my dad took it, of myself and my niece.
Yeah.
And from the picture, he had someone painted it.
Oh.
My dad, when we moved from New York, he left the painting.
Oh, gosh.
He left the painting.
Oh, no.
Oh, my goodness. If I would have had that picture up until today.
I know. I wish I had that picture. But as I said, back in the days, nobody asked the Gleaner for anything or get a copy of it. Or even, we never used to get the Gleaner. Maybe once in a while, or someone in that household or whatever in the where we're living will get the newspaper, you know, they'll have it out there sitting for a while before anyone even look at it.
But we've come a long way.
I was growing up, the culture, the people, Jamaica. Now Jamaica is reggae, skia, soca, rock steady, mento, kumina, Tati, world dance, not to mention the Jerry Springer. Jamaica is jerk pork, scotch bonnet, hardcore bread, fish and bobby, patty and cocoa bread, cornmeal dumpling, dashin, yam, pimento, akia selfish, black mango, thinking tour, drops, gizada, rum cake, banana cheese. Ah, hello, you down there. You remember Bulan here? Toto, festival, selfish fritters, woodown, mackerel and banana. Jamaica, no problem. Got pepper shrimp, blue dries, and roast breadfruit. They are. Jamaica is Miss Sue. Anansi and Big Boy story. Mass runner, Charlie, Oliver, hoy! No flaw. Jamaica is Rasta. Poco, Jankunu, Dukunu, Dipa, Fama. Nine dead yard set up. Chalice. Split. Shame old lady, grass buckle, scratch bush, mango walk, and dugu dugu. Jamaica is where be led down, cross it up, patrita, pick up the blossom, make we wheel and turn, yeah, make we wheel and turn. Jamaica's only little back to Talawa, but don't have to be conqueror. Have to watch the business in a small fight. And my favorite. Me day I wait for you from selfish a shingle house. What be a kill Philip? Why don't we sprint on the door before you come back? You see where sweet nanny goat? I go running belly. Now Jamaica is barrel from farming. And oh, me I got murka. Jamaica is rotted. Kid pupa leak. Blow woo. Blows on skirt. Sis. Second Pulo! I could go on and on and on. But the fact still remains. No matter where you go, where you're from, will always be a part of you. I am. Well, on! We're not done, we're not done, we're not done. You remember Ringia? Christian?
Oh, mama.
You remember Ringia, boy?
Oh, you mean if me remember Ringia? Good on the Manuel Road, Galamboy, big up rock, crack, stone. Sing now. Good on the Manuel Road, Galamboy, big up rock, crack, stone. We say, rock them one by one.
Galamboy.
Rock them two by two.
Galamboy.
Rock them three by three.
We have.
It's not perfect.
Nope.
But 60 years.
Yes. Can't believe it. I just cannot believe it. Yeah. And I'm not old. I'm getting better. You know, don't worry about that. Okay. I'm not old. I'm getting better.
Yeah. I'm going to start using that because I'm always saying I'm old. I'm old.
No, I'm not old.
I'm going to start saying I'm getting better.
Yeah, I'm getting better. I don't think my name and old can fit in the same sentence. No. Doesn't work like that.
Oh gosh, we have a wonderful show for you today. We have a special guest coming up. She's an awesome talent, but we'll be right back after these messages.
Estella's Legacy Book Series, first edition. Grandma Estella, I have a question.
Words are sometimes hopelessly inadequate, as is the case in attempting to sum up the dynamism, talent, achievement, and magnetism of her featured guest. Her journey was inspired in small part by her parents, especially her musician dad, Stephen Hewitt, the highly regarded guitarist who is also known was also owner of the Mighty Cloud Band. She went to the legendary performing arts troupe Kathy Levy's Little People and Teen Players. Music and the arts have taken Althea to stages across the world, throughout Europe, North and South America. Not confining herself to merely belting out tunes, Althea has also exercised her talents as songwriter, actress, and model. She has been a member of the renowned troupe Tribe Sankofa and has featured in several productions, including Hairpiece and Positive, and gone a step further to produce her own presentation, Intimate at Studio 38. Althea's leadership qualities serve in good stead during her stint as leader of the award-winning group, Fourth Street Sisters. It is my pleasure to introduce this talented young lady, Althea Hewitt. Welcome, Althea.
Oh, thank you so much.
You're welcome. Now, Althea, you have accomplished quite a lot. We weren't able to elaborate on all, but you've done so much. So how long have you been in the entertainment business?
Pretty much over 20 years. I should just say I was born in it, as you know, my dad who played guitar, the rehearsal room was right beside us. And so right. We didn't have a choice. So it's just embedded in our bloodline. It's genetics. It's everything. I got the opportunity to hear him play
for
all the years of my life. Unfortunately, he passed 3 years ago. Mm-hmm. But the music still lives within me.
Yeah. I just wanted to ask you, because sometimes if the parents are singers, they're actors or different kind of artists, they try to steer their kids away from doing the same thing they are doing. How did you manage to let him accept that you wanted to do this?
Oh boy, I remember one day, he has a little book, a theory music book. And I was just a child, I took it up and started looking through it. I grabbed it away from him and said, no, I don't want you to learn.
Yeah.
Those things drive people nuts and crazy and stuff. And I was like, okay, then I took a liking to the keyboards.
Yeah.
And from early on, I loved dancing. Dancing was actually my first love. And so when he saw it, he was like, skill, you need to get a skill in school, stay in school. But he couldn't, the way how I was at it, he had to just accept. And I became part of the band at 16 that he had. We did a couple of shows here and there, even in Old Harbor here in Kingston, Jamaica. Well, Old Harbor in the rural areas. And then he did a some shows in Kingston, Jamaica. We did shows in Silent Hill, Mandeville. So, you know, a few shows together. So I have a lot of memories with him.
Well, I guess the perseverance paid off because here you are.
That is so awesome. Besides your dad, who are some of the artists that influenced you? And I know that you've traveled all over the world. So who are some of the artists also that you've performed with?
So many. As a child growing up on black and white TV, my dad, as a matter of fact, my dad used to play these old records, these old albums, you know. So I was like, how much is that dog in the window? Yeah, you know, and these are the singers I grew up on hearing. And of course, the Alton Ellis's and the Martha Griffiths. I took a liking to Anita Baker, Regina Bell, Chaka Khan, Whitney Houston, a lot of the R&B more type singing I was drawn to. So as I got older, I fell in love with Barry Hammond because, oh my God, the man can sing, the man can perform.
Yes, that is so true.
I had to meet him one day. I mean, he was performing at some fest and I stood there at backstage and I waited for him to come in and introduce myself. And for the whole night, I was with his crew and in his space. So, I mean, there are so many other artists because as I get older, I realize that influences from different new and legendary artists still coming on. Because you have the Beyoncés, you know, you have my God, since we're just ordinary people.
Yeah, John Legend,
Yeah, there's so many. Sting. Oh my God.
Oh, Sting is the best.
And you know, the Sean Pauls of this world, the Dinah Kings and the Cheryl Franklins. So many people. So I look forward to listening to new talents as well because they also inspire you, especially if they're doing really good, positive music.
Yeah. Definitely. So you're a very versatile artist.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I am. I keep my mind open. I'm always learning. And that's the one thing that I love about myself. I always try to, you know, see different nuances, you know, how to do this a different way, how to write this a different way, how to sing it on stage a different way, how to bring forward and actually relate to my audience. So I live through other people. I live through other people and learn.
What would you say? I know that you said you've been doing this for over 20 years. What shift or what's the difference between when you started and what's happening now with music? What would you say is the greatest shift that you saw in music?
Well, the greatest one is I find that the artists of back then, I won't say the opportunities were more because there's more opportunities now, but it's as if when they're emoting their songs, the emotions, it's more, it's rich. Mm-hmm. The lyric, rich.
Yeah.
The performances were awesome. I don't find that much in the music of now.
No.
It's very hype, poppy, short living. Doesn't have much spice in it back then. And so I keep telling people, you know, I'm an old soul because, you know, give me Gladys Knight and the Pips.
And the Pips, right.
You understand? So that's my shift in the music. And then it's more money oriented, more business driven. And so they look for talent that they can make quick bucks.
Yes.
You know?
Yes.
And so because of that, it's kind of winning the essence and the passion. of music.
Of music. And I agree with you, because what I find is that music of yesteryears, you knew it word for word. As I said to my daughter, what did he just say? I don't understand a word. What did he say? You know, and you know that out there, you know, back then you knew every word, every single word. You can understand what they were saying.
Not only that, but whatever emotion you're going through, you can always find a song to relate to exactly how you're in the older song.
Yes, yes. Even with the Brandys and the Monicas and the Meredith, it's like that was the break. That was the turning point. After those singers, it's like it started to change.
Yeah.
Everything started to be much different. You'll find one or two singers now that you really hear it from the heart.
Yeah.
But everything is so electrical right now. It's robotic.
Yeah. I'm glad you said robotic, because they all sound alike. Back in the days, you could differentiate Gladys Knight from Patti LaBelle, from Aretha Franklin. You knew who was singing.
Exactly.
These days, it's like, who is that?
And even, the music.
Even the with the bands, it's all electronics now, you know?
Yeah, the music quality is, I don't know how we're going to bring it back. But I guess you have one or two that's trying to hold up a standard. And so, like myself, who, like, I love live music. I hate working with tracks. I love to be on stage with the bassy and the drum and the guitarist and the percussionist. And even if they have a horn section, or oh my goodness, you just feel so driven. You want to perform, you want to dance on stage. You just lose it when you have that combination, especially when the spirits on the stage are
the
all
vibes.
We're moving as one. Oh, and the audience is enjoying that movement. Not, I would say that any day. All right, any day. So that's what I look forward to when I go on stage.
When Paulette read your bio, we left out quite a lot, because you are a person, you're multi-talented. You're a model. You're a motivational speaker. I heard that, I read that you represented Jamaica at one point in Brussels.
Yes, I did. The Jamaica Tourist Board was involved in that one, and JamPro. That was back in 2000 something early, and we did like reggae. It was like a reggae festival, a small food reggae festival inside this, the Meridian Hotel. And the Jamaican chefs came up, and they just, the food was like, they just delivered, and then the music and the food, you know how we rock as Jamaican. We give it to them.
You must have been very proud to be asked to represent Jamaica.
Every time I'm asked to be out there, because anywhere you go, people are always asking, are you from Jamaica? And I'm always so happy to say, of course I am. And they ask a lot of questions. You try to answer, as much as you can. And I find most of the times that they themselves know more than us, because when they come here, they're not sucking it, and they're going all around the island and finding the little, spots that we've never been before. And so I made my point of duty to make a bucket list. So I do try to find the spots, so that when anybody asks me anything, I say, man, of course I've been there. Yeah.
You know what's funny? Whenever I go somewhere and there are Jamaican people there, they'll ask, where are you from? Jamaica. Like, no, you're not. So I have a hard time with that. But it's like sometimes, when people are around, they're having a discussion, and I'm a Jamaican, I want to shout out, I'm a Jamaican, but they never think I'm a Jamaican. But, I'm so proud
mm-hmm.
of that small little island, you know?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes. It has accomplished so much. And it's renowned all over the world.
It is. It's everywhere you go, you have Jamaicans are there. For every part, everywhere that I have been, there's a Jamaican there. And sometimes I'll hear the accent and I'm like, oh, a Jamaican is close by. Wow. You know, like, what are you doing here? I saw one and he was selling jewelry in Greece. I'm like,
oh,
how did this happen? How the hell did you get here?
What's that saying? We're big and we're broad.
Yes, yes, exactly.
And then so we're little, but we tell
our channel.
Yes. I remember, I don't know if it was Jenny, one of our hosts here from Jamaica. But somebody's relating a story that they were somewhere in Europe in a train station and they lost their way. Or it was in America somewhere, they lost their way and then nobody was speaking their language. So, you know, everybody was doing their own thing and she didn't know who to speak to. So she busts out a big old lozama and say, lecture that say, no one for find which part, no one for go. And she's talking but and she hears some big loud echo way down the way that somebody, you know, we say. And then she just joined up, but that's how she found her way out of the train station because nobody spoke the language.
Right.
That's why, you know, we always try to pick up a patois because
mm-hmm.
we ourselves didn't realize how important it is how we sound to other people out there right. when they, you know, speak. Right. When we speak English, everybody's like, nah, man, you don't sound like Jamaican. Once you open your mouth and start talking like a patois, it's like,
Yeah, exactly. They're pointy and stuff. And it gets to the point where there are people who try to adopt or try to speak the patois and stuff. I saw on a YouTube thing, there was this British lady in the middle of one of the squares there in London. She was singing Barrington Levy, you know.
Oh, I saw that.
Song. Yes. And I'm like, she's just really singing it good. And everybody, and then of course the Jamaican is back there. Bow, bow, bow.
like the Jamaicans, we are supporting our culture.
You know.
Man, we're such good. A proud people when we want to be, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And that's one of the things that I especially right now in the festive season, I try to drive, especially with my festivals on at Nairobi, because I'm saying, you know, we're losing that flavor. We're losing our people to a lot of things. And I think COVID did not quite help the situation for some. But hopefully we will have a turnaround and fix a lot of what the crime elements and
mm-hmm.
all the other things that's really the lyrical content in the music here is terrible. It's causing a lot of it's like, as I say, you have to be careful what you say put out there because words are powerful. I write motivational songs and love songs and
mm-hmm.
I try my best to talk to people and pass on it. As a matter of fact, recently I was talking to somebody about being here in spirit, being positive because, you know, if you bring that in everyone's space, you enter. So the way how words are, that's what you bring to people. Mm-hmm. You're going to bring negative, it's going to just wash into their system, into their bloodstream, and they're going to pass it on to other people.
Exactly.
So we have to be careful of what we share. Oh yeah, so that's one of the things I'm hoping that they'll be for the rest of 2022. They'll be cleaning up all of that mess, the criminals, the lyrics, just everything, the politics, everything needs a redo. From my angle, actually.
Same here, Althea. Same here. It's no different from Jamaica. I swear to God, we need a whole revamping of what's going on here. But I noticed you mentioned your festival song. So I'm taking that this is one This is an original music for you. Have you done any other in the past? Do you have albums or singles?
Yes, I do. I have one festival song before, which was entered in the competition in 2021. That one is called Jamaica Nice. Mm-hmm. I had fun. There's a bit stressing. I did not expect to be chosen. I wasn't expecting. So I was in a bit of a shock when they called and said I was in the 12, but the song is up on YouTube, Jamaica Nice. This year, when I entered in the last opening, because Honorable Babsick Green said, we can't find any songs, yada, 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 so we're not going to do this. And then they said, nope, open back that portal and try to get in more songs so that they can have a festival song competition this year. Mm-hmm. And that's when I wrote a song called Walk With Your Flag, Jamaica. So I said, as a songwriter, I could submit it and see what happens. And it wasn't chosen. But because it has 60 all over the song, I said, you know what? You only 60 once. So I'm going to put it out. So It came out on the 29th of July. And the video is coming out tomorrow at 8 p.m. The festival itself, what I've done is I have just released my song, like other Jamaican artists who did their songs and actually put it in. So they have put out, so you have a lot of festival songs that are out now. Uh-huh. And I'm a part of that lot for 2022 that we have decided. We've put out our songs out there and we are going to promote it for the independence, because as you know, we love Jamaica, and this is one way in which to show how much we really appreciate being here.
So when will you know which one, who wins for this?
No, actually, the competition, Friday night. Was it Friday night or Saturday night? It's already finished. Sakaj, a young lady, she won.
Oh,
I saw something on YouTube about that name, but I wasn't sure. I thought it was still, the competition was still going on.
Yeah, I realized that they're having a bit of a, I don't know if it's a malfunction or it's a complaint that we've been having from last year, that they're very behind the time. When in the competition, they should have been preparing from, say, September, November, to get seeing all these people together.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Workshop, whatever it is, let them know what they are looking for.
Exactly.
And so the year start, we have songs that are entered, groomed, and ready for the competition. So by the time February comes in, March, they're doing, they know exactly the dates, they're doing the road shows, they're all over the place. COVID kind of messed up, well, I won't say COVID, but maybe there are other factors as well that the artists themselves didn't get a chance to tour and get to promote their stuff. So that was one of the shortcomings of the competition for the last 2-3 years that it's been, you know, the fluctuation is not at its peak, at its best,
right.
I should say. And right now, we have a lot of disgruntled people. See, you guys didn't even know that the competition is already gone.
No, yeah. I'm still voting.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's my problem with me. Trust me, I'm a part of a group. We're so upset. We're saying, no, man, we need to, as a festival, Jamaica festival, and part of the whole reggae culture branding, it should start a little earlier, and so people can know, get it promoted, so everybody in the diaspora can know what's happening. And that's one of the reasons that I said earlier that we released our songs, because we love Jamaica and we want to show that, which how we feel about Jamaica, instead of waiting on all this backward kind of thing that's happening. Right now, hopefully it will be fixed by next year.
Yeah.
You know, with a lot of talking. So we're going to be submitting letters to the Prime Minister, to the Honorable Bassey Green, to the JCDC. I'm sure there's a lot of that going on right now. So everything is much better put together for next year. So everybody knows and everybody's aware of 2023 festival competition.
Was it because they sort of like, how would I put it? Was it because they weren't going to have it and then last minute they decide to do it? Could that be the factor?
Well, you know, as I said, I think we have a lot of factors working in the background. And when you try to get into the politics of it, it's you just say, you know, Lord, I'm going to leave it in your hands, because the only thing you can do is talk to the people who are responsible for that to see if they can make a change, do something better, you know, fix it. Fix it so other people can understand what they need for the competition, because a lot of people is like, oh, they like the old and traditional feel, or they want a little touch on the new feel, because, you know, the kids catch things very easily if you promote it properly. So depending on them, because the people like to be involved, like you want to be involved. So you want to hear what they're putting out there so that you can say, nah, that don't sound good. Or, yeah, I love this song. So, you know, that's the thing that we're looking for, that they can get the people back in Jamaica involved in the festival competition.
Wow, that's a lot of changes that were made, because I remember back in the days, they would be playing all those songs and everybody is voting and stuff. Meeting the artists and stuff like that, but that didn't happen this year.
No, they just threw it on people. Yeah. I mean,
Exactly, just like
throw it on people.
It just happened.
Yes, My gosh, that is so bad.
Well, I am excited, Althea, because you're going to be performing for us for our Jamaica 60th.
Yes.
And I'm looking forward to that. I'm sorry that you had to use a track. I know you don't like to use tracks, but we so appreciate the fact that you're going to be performing for us. And I am looking forward to it. But I want to thank you for taking the time to come on to do this interview with us, because I know that you're very tired. You did two shows last night. So yes. I'm so appreciative that you took the time to come on and to be on Bashment Bay Show. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Yeah, so thank you very much.
It's always a pleasure. And anytime you guys need me, I can call. You know that.
Yeah.
It's always wonderful to do something and feel good about doing it, you know. That's right. What I try my best to not, if I'm going to take something, I want to get it done 110%. And I'm a vibes girl. I'm a spirit person. Like, I go with my spirit. I don't run down money. I'm not the kind of person who, you know, equate, okay, so you give me this little bit of money, you're going to get this little bit of performance. Or, you know, yeah, people think that way. And I'm really just the kind of person that if I am asked, and I have the time, I'm going to do it. And I'm going to give you my all. And I do hope your audience enjoys the performance. And I was in my little t-shirt and my jeans and my little flannel. I was celebrating Malika, Jamaica. Yes, so, you know, I do hope you all enjoy it.
I am sure that we all will, because they love when you performed for us before. They love that. So they will certainly enjoy this performance. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Althea.
Go and get some rest.
Yes. Thank you.
We'll be right back.
My love, she kept on.
everyone. Greetings. My name is Althea Hewitt, and I want to say happy Emancipation Day when it comes. Happy Independence Day out of Kingston, Jamaica, all Jamaicans here in Jamaica and in the diaspora. I want you to have an awesome and wonderful festive season, okay? Enjoy.
Let's get the show on the road, ladies and gentlemen.
This is reggae music.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome to the sound.
Come on. La 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 la, rock with me. Oh, it's a struggle now.
I want freedom.
Oh, it's a struggle now. Oh, it's a struggle now. Rock with me. Tear down the walls of black. Tear down the walls of white. So tired of talking about equal rights and justice. Hey, stand up cause against inequity. It's a struggle now.
I cry freedom. Yeah.
Oh, it's a struggle now.
I cry freedom.
Ooh. Oh, it's a struggle now. See me. Put your hands together like this. Come on. Hey. Oh, it's such a struggle. Oh, he's time for change. Struggle. Every day. Now I know you know this one. It's called Holding Back the Years. I want you to sing the chorus with me. Yeah. Here we go now. I'll keep holding on. I'll keep holding on a little louder. I'll keep holding on. Oh my goodness. Oh yeah. Holding on. Yeah.
Oh,
gotta keep holding on.
Yeah. It doesn't matter where you come from. Respect the future of the ladies. Cause I'm in here, that's no woman show me no respect. A human fanatic, so show me no respect. Cause I'm in here, that's no woman show me no respect. Hey. Okay, I'm in here, the center room, I show me no respect. I show me living out of ghetto, show me no respect. Okay, I'm in here, the center room, I show me no respect. Yeah. Because this is a fact, me have to confess. All of the woman has with you respect. Now do we dress up in the latest and we're fancying it. When you show up on the street, the man them say we look fresh. We jack man, and then we're interested. So tell them get bright. What is it they are to see? Them a pop up, them make them not see me see how we them start get all set. I care me name, that's when I'm in my show me no respect. That's when me living and they get to show me no respect. Now care me name, that's when I'm in my show me no respect. Lord, no respect, hey! I care me name, that's when I'm in my show me no respect. That's when me living and they get to show me no respect. I care me name, that's when I'm in my show me no respect. No respect, no respect, hey! This one, big ups in that each other, day. Action, sweet. Action, sweet. You think you are so fine. Stop playing with my mind. You call me on the phone, and I want you to know, action, sweet, action, sweet, I need some action, tender satisfaction, my chemistry is flowing, can you cause a chain reaction? I need some action, not tender satisfaction. My chemistry is flowing, can you cause a chain reaction? Hey, oh Lada, mercy, mercy, mercy. My man, I be all of them sexy, all the shy men. Watch them dance, follow me. Have mercy, mercy, mercy. Follow them now, move me. I shy man, I want more what you want to. I. Everywhere me go, the man, they might rush me. Cause I will property boy, I want to love me. Me, them love. Me, them love. To them, no me sweet and me sexy. Everywhere me go, me say me ever ready. Me, them love. Me, them love. I don't want somebody who's loving everybody. I need a shout out. Kind of guy who loves every man. Oh, Lord, have mercy, mercy. To my name and I party, party. They say they all of them sexy, hey. Watch them, this a. Oh, follow me, follow me, follow me. Mercy, mercy, mercy. None of them no moment, moment. I shine on the one more want to want it. And only can make me angry, angry. Listen. Roughneck man, me no want none of them. Beat up my body, lick off me head top. Me no want none of them. I'm too blessed to be stressed. Ladies, too blessed to sing it with me. Too blessed to be. Oh, we're too blessed to be stressed. Come on now. Don't let me my, oh Lord, have mercy, mercy. The man them in a party, party. Me say they all are them sexy, sexy. So watch them, the sun. Follow me, have mercy, mercy, mercy. And then I'm on the moment. I shine my number, my want to, want it. I don't even can make me angry, angry. Have mercy, 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 mercy. Shut my woman say, Lord of his mercy. Come on now. Shine my new one here, you hold up your one in the air and make me eyes. If you wanna one of them, you don't wanna see you. So dedicated to all the shy man pro, yeah. Shy man, me wanna hear you. All of you in the air, I'm in my eyes. You. If you wanna of them, me now wanna see you. So dedicated to all you.
I don't want somebody who's loving everybody. Shaka, haka, who don't let me mind. I need a shaka. So I'm gonna say, have mercy, mercy, mercy. No, 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 move me, move me. The shine, my number, my want it, want it. And no name can make me irie, irie, irie.
Thank you so much so far. Listen, happy Independence Day. This is my festival song for 2022. Walk with your flag. Come on, everybody, dance to it. Come on, you ready?
Walk, swing your hips. Walk with your flag, walk with your flag. Hey, walk with your flag for all of the kingdom. Walk, dip. Walk, I miss a walk like this. Walk with your flag, walk with your flag. Hey, walk with your flag. Oh, kings and queens of Jamaica, Talawa and Strong. 6 years of freedom. To the hills and the valleys and the rivers and the streams of another beautiful sky. Independence celebration, back over excited. 60 years we are alive. Jamaica, viva, viva. 60 years we are alive. Jamaica, viva, Jamaica, viva. Independence celebration. How you mean? 60 years we are alive. Jamaica, viva. Jamaica, viva. 60 years we are alive. Jamaica, viva. Jamaica, viva. Come on, follow me now. Hey,
well, I got the hurdles, need the cross. Let me follow me, make we clear the path. The hurdles we need to cross. Follow me, make we watch it. Wine and you wiggle on you. Wine and you wiggle on you to sun you. Wine and you wiggle on you to sun you.
60 years we are alive.
Walk, dip, come on.
Walk,
sing. We can hear that.
Walk with your flag. Walk with your flag.
Come. Thank you so much for hanging with me. I'm even sweating over here. I hope you busted a sweat or two. Thank you so much. I have one more beautiful song for you. And I know you're gonna love this one. Happy Independence Day when it comes.
Those schoolgirl days,
oh,
setting tails and burning nails are gone. But in my mind, I know they will. Still live on and on.
from crayons to perfume.
Welcome back. We hope you enjoyed the show and we hope you enjoy Althea Hewitt, who was our guest performer today. And we hope that you had a wonderful celebration of Jamaica's 60th anniversary. We will see you on Sunday, August 21st, where our next topic will be on sexual abuse. We'll see you then.
You know, I wanted to have a show on this topic for quite some time. Because it's like almost every other female that I speak with, I've gone through this trauma. And I went to an event this past weekend, and it was like a sisterhood type of meeting. And they were honest and open and the same thing. You know, all this sexual abuse, I feel it's a discussion to be had. We must talk about this subject. So I do hope that you will join us on Sunday, August 21st, for this serious and important conversation. I would like to thank Althea Hewitt. That was just so awesome that you took the time to do all these songs for us. Thank you. Thank you so much. Charmaine Limonius. And Mary Isaac for sending us that original song that you did. I hope everyone enjoyed that. So thank you all for watching. Chris still isn't back. He's back, but he's quite busy right now. So as soon as he's settled, he'll be back. So until next time, cheers.
Here's my bottle of water. And by the way, my blouse, I got to show you my blouse, Jamaica 60th. There we are.
Yes, and I have to show off this piece that Charmaine Limonius sent me all the way from Jamaica last year because I didn't have anything with, you know, representing Jamaica. So thank you, Charmaine.
Thank you, that's a beautiful piece.
I love it. I love it. Thank you so much.
Bye.
It's a long time, girl, we never see you. Come let me hold your hand. This long time, girl, we never see you. Come let me hold your hand. Dile, Jankos, sit on Patrita, pick up the blessing. Let me hold your hand, girl. Let me hold your hand. And this long time, girl, we never see you. Come let me walk and talk. And this long time, girl, we never see you. Come let me walk and talk. Let me hold your hand. girl you never see. Come back with me, Lanton. Village and cross the long battery to pick up the glass up. Make me wheel and turn, girl. Make me wheel and turn. Make me wheel and turn till we tumble down. Make me hold your hand, girl. Make me wheel and turn till we tumble down. Make me hold your hand, girl. Make me wheel and turn till we tumble down. Make me hold your hand, girl. Make me wheel and turn till we tumble down. Make me hold your hand, girl.
Tune in to Bashment Bay.